Whenever we run our class, we run the method public static void main string square bracket args. I'll draw a stack frame to keep track of the local variables. And I wrote the name of the method main on the side. The first line says int square bracket, that's an int array. Int array nums a, gets the value new int, and then in square brackets we have 3. Oops, I'm sorry, in the square brackets we have 4. So int array, that's int square brackets, nums a, creates a new variable named nums a, and that can hold a reference. And here it's going to hold a reference to an int array. The right hand side, new int, and then in square brackets it says 4, that creates an int array with 4 elements. That's just 4 int variables glued next to each other. And our default value for ints is going to be 0, so all of these are zeros, even though it's a little hard to see. That equals sign, that says nums a gets the value of a reference to that int array. So nums a is a reference to that int array. Our next line says int array, or int square bracket, nums b gets the value of nums a. So that creates a variable nums b, and nums b is a variable that can hold a reference. It says int array nums b gets the value of num a. So nums b is going to get a copy of what's in nums a. So nums b gets a copy of what's in nums a. So now they both reference that same array. So nums a and nums b both reference that same array. As a side note, they'd be equal to each other. The next line says nums a gets new int array 6. So we were resetting nums a with this assignment statement. And when we're resetting a variable or using a variable, we don't list the type. We only list it the first time we create it. So we say nums a gets the value of a new int array with 6 elements. So here's my new int array with 6 elements. And nums a will get reset. So it'll no longer reference the 4 element array. It now references this 6 element array. So can you see nums a references my 6 element array, and nums b will reference my 4 element array.